bam, this is true. Well, we got done talking about the multiplication property and the power property of exponents. Now let's move on to the division property. Now, if you multiply like bases, and when you multiply like bases, if you add the exponents, guess what you do with division? The inverse of multiplication. Well, what's the inverse of the inverse math operation of addition? That's subtraction. So, first example here, we have x to the fifth over x squared. Now, this property says that when you divide like bases, you're supposed to subtract the exponent. So, you know, this answer is supposedly x to the fifth, x to the 5 minus 2, you subtract down, so 5 minus 2 power, and that is equal to x to the third. Now, if you don't believe that, then you can take this and let's just expand it. X to the fifth power. Something to the fifth power means you're multiplying by that base 5 times. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 x's. In the denominator, we have x squared. So we have 2 x's. Well, also remember that anything divided by itself is equal to 1. So x divided by x is 1. X divided by x is again 1, and x times x times x, the last time I checked, was equal to x to the third. Now that's not a proof, I'm just showing you that with this expansion, if you just understand what exponents do, just by expanding those exponents, x to the fifth and x squared, you're going to get to the same answer. So yes, indeedy, when you divide like bases, you subtract those exponents. Okay. Also, as we go through this video, and I do have quite a few examples, a couple of things. One, I'm going to make sure that all of our answers have positive exponents, because I'm going to deal with negative exponents and powers of zero in the next video and explain to you how the division property will allow you to see why is it anything to the zero power is equal to one. This is an example. Also, I'm not going to write a condition every time I put up a new example, so we're just going to assume that all these variables are going to be set up or have restrictions of in their domain so that we'll never divide by zero. So like for this problem, x can't be equal to zero or y can't be equal to zero because the whole problem would be undefined. It'd be pointless trying to simplify the fraction, the rational expression. So here we have x to the seventh over x to the fourth. Let's just say it this way. X to the seventh times y squared over x to the fourth times y to the first. Don't need to write that one there, but if you're just learning this, you might need it. Now, how do you do this? If you really go with this, you know, if you're catching on this really quick, before long you will be able to do this in your head. However, I'm just teaching it, so I'm going to show all the work. We have a variable of x, so I'm gonna pair up all the variables that are in the numerator and denominator, or just the numerator alone, and sort of give them their own little piece here. So we're going to take the x and write that as x to the 7 minus 4 power times, because along the top of this fraction, and the bottom for that matter, but along the top of this fraction, all of these factors are being multiplied together. You can't do any of these. All these examples we're going to do today are going to have one term on the numerator and one term in the denominator. If you start having pluses and minuses in here, that's quite a bit of a different story in how to simplify those fractions. So we have x to the 7 minus 4, because we're dividing like bases. We're dividing the y's. There's a common base of y in the numerator and denominator, so it's going to be y to the 2 minus 1 power. And x to the 7 minus 4 is x to the 3rd, and 2 minus 1 is equal to 1. So it's x cubed times y to the 1st. Really, again, you don't really have to write that. Here, we have a fraction, and the whole fraction is being raised to the second power. Well, power to power property. Anytime you have those stacked exponents, you are going to need to apply the power property. And again, remember, there's no pluses and minuses in the numerator or denominator. It's one term over one term. So because of that, and because of the fact that we have these stacked exponents, I'm going to go ahead and give this 3 a exponent of 1 so we can see it, and we're going to kind of like to do the distributive property. We're doing the power property. Every single one of the exponents that are in this fraction, again, where there's a monomial on top and a monomial in the denominator, each one of those exponents are going to get that power of 2. So I'm going to do the power to power to each one of those exponents. Okay, so we have 3, 1 times 2 is 2. So we're going to have 3 squared, x cubed. Now that 3 times 2 is equal to 6, so we're going to have x to the 6th over negative. Now I'm going to wrap that negative sign up in a set of parentheses. I've talked about in other videos how negative 2 to the, say, even power of 2 is different than negative 2 to the second power. This equals positive 4, and this equals negative 4, because exponents only act on what they're sitting right above. So because there is a set of parentheses around this entire fraction, and a fraction bar itself acts as a grouping symbol, we're going to keep this negative y in the parentheses and have negative y raised to the, now, within this denominator, this negative is not being affected by this exponent of 2. But this negative is inside this parenthesis, and there's a power on the outside of that parenthesis. You see, I'm not writing a big fraction or a big set of parentheses around the entire fraction. So it's not there's a parenthesis here. It's that this big parenthesis is coming down and just wrapping around that negative y to the second. So we have negative y, 2 times 2 is equal to 4. Okay, so get this out of the way. We're almost done. We have 3 squared, which is equal to 9. We have x to the 6th, and then negative y to the 4th power. Or, you know, negative y to the 2 times 2 is again 4th power. So that's going to be negative y times negative y is positive y squared. And then to the 4th power again, which is going to be negative y to the 3rd, and then to another power, the 4th power, it's going to be positive y to the 4th. Hope that made sense as I was saying it. I wasn't sure if it was sounded right. So we have 9x to the 6th power over y to the 4th. I've got 4 more examples, so I'll be right back. Next two. Get a little more complicated as we move along here. We have 2 r to the 4th x to the 3rd raised to the 2nd power, it's just the numerator that has that power of 2 now, not the entire fraction, over 3r squared times x to the 4th. Well, we need to follow the order of operations, and of course that means exponents before division, so we're going to take that stacked exponent situation here, remembering there's only one term inside this grouping symbol, and apply that power to power, and let's not forget that 2 has an exponent of 1. So that becomes 2 to the 2nd power, r, 4 times 2 is 8, and then x to the 3 times 2, which is the 6th power, over 3r squared, x to the 4th, and let's not forget, of course, you know, 2 squared is equal to 4, so let's just change that here because I'm going to run out of space if I don't. We have 4/3. We have an r on the top and the bottom, or numerator and denominator. We're going to subtract those exponents. So we have r to the 8 minus 2, which is equal to 6. And then we have a base of x in the numerator and denominator. And of course, when you divide like bases, 6 minus 4 is equal to 2. So we have 4/3 r to the 6th, x squared. Make sure to make some silly mistake. That's what my notes say, too. Now here, we have a numerical base. That can throw students off, and a lot of students want to say 3 divided by 3 is equal to 1, but I don't cancel the r's out and say that it's 1 to the 6th power. We have a common base of r, and we don't know what the base is, so your only arithmetic you can see to do is with the exponent, which is correct. If you do know what that base is, it doesn't change anything. We're going to, you know, we are dividing like bases. So we're going to copy that common base of 3, and remember that when we divide like bases, we subtract the exponent. So it's going to be k plus 4 minus 2. That comes out to be 4 minus 2 is equal to 2. And your teacher might be perfectly happy with that form of the answer. However, I'm not. We have a base with two terms being added together in the exponent. Now, when do you add exponents? You add exponents, and that's what we have here. We have addition in the exponent. We add exponents when we multiply like bases. So we can take a step further and simplify this more by remembering that, okay, so we must have had, or we can rewrite this so that we have a common base of 3, and with that addition sign, we can rewrite this as 3 to the k times 3 squared. Huh. Okay, right? Multiplying like bases, we can add those exponents. Yes, that is what we would get. So this is an equivalent expression, and now 3 squared is equal to 9. So it's 9 times 3 to the k power. And I've got two more examples. So let's get to them. Last two. Woo! They look like a bit of a mess, don't they? Well, just take it, you know, little by little. We have exponents. You have to do exponents. Can you see that? That's 3 to the power of 3 there. You have to do exponents before you multiply or divide. So we're going to apply this power to power. So we have, give everything its own exponent, and let's attack or do that power to power with each of those factors. And again, no addition or subtraction in the numerator denominators. Monomial, 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 monomial. That's when the power to power rule works. See, the monomial, one thing. Okay, so that means that we have 2 to the 1 times 2 or second power. 2 to the second power is 4, so we have 4. X to the third to the second power is x to the sixth. We have y to the fourth to the second power, which is y to the eighth, times, now, negative x squared to the third power. Let's just take that little bit out there for a second. Negative x squared to the third power. That is negative x squared times negative x squared times negative x squared. Sometimes if you have a little bit of a question about a piece of a complicated problem like these, pull it out and just, you know, look at it in a tiny little piece. Negative x squared to the third power, because again we have that negative in there and that can, you know, be a little bit difficult. This parenthesis is representing that big one that's around the entire fraction again. I know that this base does not have its own parentheses. But it is negative x squared to the third. So negative 1 times negative 1 is 1 times negative 1 is negative 1. And then x to the second, x to the fourth, and now we have x to the sixth. So we still do want that negative sign. It's being maintained by the fact that it's being raised to an odd power. If this were even, the negative would cancel out. So we have negative x to the sixth, y to the ninth, applying that power to power property, we're multiplying all the exponents, and then z to the third. Okay. Well, now what do we have? We have not much that'll cancel. We can cancel now or cancel later. We have 8y's in the denominator, we have 9 in the numerator, so we're going to end up with just 1y in the numerator when we're done, but I think I'll do that at the end. 4 times negative 1 is negative 4. We have x to the 6 times x to the 6, which is x to the 12. Now, why am I doing addition and not multiplying? Because this x has, or this 6 has its own base of x, this 6 has its own common base of x, and when you multiply like bases, you add the exponents. We don't have stacked exponents. We're not multiplying. We're not doing power to power. And then there's the 9, or y to the 9th, excuse me, over y to the 8th over z, or times z to the 3rd. Now, we have a common base in the numerator and denominator, the y's. When you divide like bases, probably better if I had these stacked vertically, but when you divide like bases, that's what a fraction bar is, division, you subtract the exponents. So, our final answer is going to be negative 4 x to the 12th, 9 minus 8 is equal to 1, so y to the first over z to the third power. Here, well, a fraction bar is a big grouping symbol. And in the numerator, I have a common base of x. And when you multiply like bases, you add the exponents. So this is going to become x to the k plus 3 plus 2k minus 1 over x to the k power. All this adds up to k times k is 3k, and 3 minus 1 is 2, so x to the 3k plus 2 over x to the k. And now we're dividing like bases. Now that I've simplified the numerator as much as possible, when you divide like bases, you subtract the exponents. So we have x to the 3k plus 2 minus k. And 3k minus 1k is 2k. So we have x to the 2k plus 2. A lot of this manipulation we're doing at this point with these problems, you know, you're not going to see, you know, someone doing a day-to-day basis in their everyday life, but these algebraic skills and techniques that we're using is building up and building up. We're going to go through, you know, algebra 1, algebra 2, whatever you're in now, into pre-calculus, and then really when you get into calculus, it's the first time some of these techniques you really see getting used in problems that you really can understand why we care about learning this, how it applies to the real life. The calculus will give you enough power in that algebra, along with the idea of limits and, you know, like a Babylon, but you really see where all this algebra can get tied into some careers, like if you're an engineer or something like that, designing, you know, the things that we just happen to use every day. All this math does apply to real life, you know, either immediately if you're doing something like percents, or eventually if you're doing all this manipulation of all these exponents. So, I'm Mr. Tarrou. Let's talk about some negative exponents and power of zero in the next video. Or you can go do your homework. Yes. I wrote a note at the bottom of my paper here. With all these simplification problems, you know you're done when the coefficients are relatively prime. That doesn't mean that the coefficients are themselves prime, but the coefficients of the numerator compared to the denominator. Each base appears only once. We had a base here that showed up twice, and I wasn't done until we had that y only showing up once. And there are no powers of powers. Like we had here that we had to simplify as well. Now we're done.